The Nook HD Plus is a 9-inch tablet with a stunning full HD screen. It's thin and fairly light at just over 500 grams, and like Amazon's Kindle Fire tablets, it runs a heavily customized version of Google Android. The soft rubber back makes the tablet comfortable to hold either way round. The screen's full HD resolution is a joy to behold. Everything looks sharp and detailed, and as it's an IPS panel, viewing angles are excellent. Films and TV shows look great, and reading a book or magazine is just about the nicest experience short of the real printed versions. Although the Nook's soft operating system looks nothing like Android, it's easy to use and lets you create separate user accounts which can be password protected. There are good parental controls too, and you can choose exactly which books, apps, games, and websites your kids can access. When it originally launched, both Nook HD tablets were locked into Barnes & Noble's world, so if you wanted to install an app, buy a book or subscribe to a magazine or newspaper, it had to be from the Nook store. However, Barnes & Noble has opened a gate in its walled garden and allowed Google Play in. That means you have access to a huge range of apps and games, just as you do on any Android tablet. In Google Play, you can also buy films, music and magazines. Another change is that the old web browser has been replaced by Google Chrome. And if you use Google Chrome on your PC, it means you can easily sync bookmarks, logins and more. Browsing is zippy enough, but gone is support for Flash, so you end up with the same issues as the iPad, although you could install a different browser from Google Play, of course. You also get Gmail, YouTube and Google Maps apps preloaded. One thing that hasn't changed is the lack of an option to install apps from other sources, so there's no sideloading of apps from, say, Amazon's App Store. Amazon's Kindle HD 8.9 is the Nook HD Plus's closest rival, but its dark interface looks cheerless by comparison. Both tablets lack a camera, so you can't use their big screens for Skype video calls. The HD Plus is designed to be used portrait and has a volume rocker and headphone socket on top. A sleep-wake button is on the right-hand side, and you'll find a proprietary dock connector and a useful microSD card slot on the bottom edge. It's a shame that there's no standard micro USB port, nor an HDMI output though. On the back is a mono speaker, and the strange hole serves no purpose at all. With a fast dual-core processor, the HD Plus should be as slick and fluid as the best tablets. Our benchmarks threw up no worrying results, but in use, the Nook was sometimes slow to respond, whether loading an app or just navigating through menus. Animations, such as the carousel of recent apps and content, also stutters from time to time. Chances are you're choosing between the Nook HD Plus, Kindle Fire HD 8.9 and possibly an iPad mini. The iPad is perhaps the easiest to dismiss. It's more expensive, has a much lower resolution screen, and a new version is surely on the cards in the not too distant future. The lack of cameras will be a turnoff for some, but despite this and the stuttery interface, the HD Plus is easy to recommend.